Welcome to this week's Cybersecurity Minute. This week, we're going to talk about wireless hacking. And as we're just going to start actually a new series here going on through wireless hacking. And the first thing we have to do before we can start hacking wireless networks is ensure that we have the right equipment. So the first piece of equipment that I want to use is what's called a wireless router, right? Or a wireless access point. This is a standard one. I'm sure you have one laying around the house. Almost everyone does. This is an old one I used to have. It's called an N300. It's made by Netgear. You could pick these up for about $10 or $15 online on eBay or Amazon or something like that. The nice thing about this is it has a wireless B, wireless G, and wireless N modes. It also does support 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz modes. So I can set up a practice network, give it a password, and then try to attack it. Again, this is just going to be a standard wireless access point with a router combined. It does have four access points for your wired network, as well as the yellow one you see there, which is going to give us our internet access. In our case, we're probably not going to even hook it up to the internet because we just want a wireless network to be able to practice our hacking on. Now, the second thing you're going to need is you're going to need a network card that allows you to go into what's called promiscuous mode, as well as one that allows you to do packet injection. And so the one I actually like is this one right here, and you can see here, it is the 36NH. If you search for Alpha Networks 36NH on Amazon, you'll be able to find it. They run about $30 to $35, and they come with everything you need right in the box. They are a USB-style network card, it plugs in with USB 2.0. The nice thing about these is they come with the 5 decibel antenna already attached, and you can plug these in and any Linux or OS X machine or even Windows will be able to run it without using drivers. So if you're using Kali Linux as your attack platform like we usually do in our courses, you plug this in and Kali's going to detect it right away when you boot it up. There's no need to mess with drivers or software. And we'll be able to use that with all of our Kali Linux wireless attack tools. The other thing that's really nice about this is if you have a signal that's too weak to be detected by this, you can actually take off this antenna, this 5 dB antenna, and you can swap it out with a 9 dB antenna. Now this runs about $5 to $10 on Amazon. Again, it's made by Alpha Networks. This one is called a N19 antenna, an ARS N19. And this is set up again for 2.4 gigahertz scale, so wireless B, G, or N. And it's going to give you 9 decibel of pickup, which is going to allow you to just screw it on. And now you have this long 18-inch, what my wife likes to call the magic wand, and it can actually pick up the signal from much further away. Now, if you're actually trying to do things from across the street or even further distances, one of the nice tricks that we can use is we can take a Pringles can, put it over the end of this, and it will actually directionalize this omnidirectional antenna to go one direction and pick up things from a much further range as well. So again, these are just some of the small little tools and techniques that I use as I build my wireless hacking network, and then I use the tools to actually exploit it. We'll go into it next time when we actually start breaking apart what is WEP and how are we going to crack WEP in the next Cybersecurity Minute.